All right, the exciting new thing in Photoshop 2021 is what they call the neural filters. These are essentially like super fancy skin retouching apps and other types of advanced features that a lot of people are saying are going to put retouchers out of business. So there's a skin retouching thing, which to me looks like it's pretty bad. It looks like a very bad amateurish skin retouching. When I turn the blur down, doesn't help much. Can play with the smoothness. I don't know if this is something that's useful to me. You can do a style transfer. Let's see what this does. Cool. It's pretty bad. I don't know why anyone would want to use this, but it looks like Photoshop of 1997. Now these are the beta filters. Some of the smart portrait stuff is where the real potential lies. So we can adjust the happiness of this picture. So if I crank it up to 50, yeah, that's super creepy. Let's turn the happiness down. Yeah, that's weird. It's just weird. Here's back to original. Now let's look at the surprise slider. Gonna max it out first. Okay, I don't know what's going on with the teeth or any of that. I think that in general the idea is interesting, but obviously the implementation isn't quite ready yet. Anger. Let's see what it looks like when I'm angry with this smiling picture. Woo! Let's turn the anger down. This is least angry version. Wow. Now, facial age is really interesting. If I make it maximum young, you see that it smooths the skin, kind of narrows my face a little bit, makes my hair more brown. Interesting. And then to make it old, it basically adds a couple pounds, makes everything white, adds more wrinkles. This is like a Snapchat filter, just not quite as good, maybe. Gaze is really interesting to me. You can make the pupils look left or right, which is extremely valuable in group pictures or portraits where sometimes people just won't look into the camera. This is pretty awesome. And you can micro adjust it to just the right spot. Now, there are ways to do this with liquify and warp mesh and things, but this is a pretty handy way to quickly do a bunch of photos at a time. Hair thickness, I can thin it out. It's not great, but it's okay. And then the thickened hair looks so bad. Head direction, similar sort of thing. You can tilt the direction of the head as though someone's looking left or right. Again, if somebody is just looking way off to the side, this might be helpful. But as you can see, it's like some sort of fish that has its eyes on the side of its head. I don't know if this is quite ready for prime time. It is a beta feature. This is not final. Now, this light direction is super cool. The light in this actual picture was coming from pretty much straight on with a ring light, but we can make it look like there was a strong key light off the camera right or a camera left. So on that side, it looks decent. This side, not quite as good. It's still a pretty compelling feature, and I love to see where this might go in the future. And then you can do things like transfer makeup from one photo to the other. If you've done a bunch of retouching or you've made someone have purple lips or something, you can batch do photos, which would be super cool. This depth aware, this is the wrong photo for this. Here's an outdoor portrait photo that's kind of a better fit for this depth aware filter. So you can see that there's haze. I can increase the amount of haze behind her. And you can see that the edge detection is pretty poor, but if you use it with restraint, it's not too bad. It's a nice way to enhance the picture in a certain way. And of course, you can remove the haze, which is just sort of like a sharpening filter, which is kind of cool. And then this warmth aspect is really interesting. I can cool it off, and it doesn't cool off the subject. It just cools off the background, which can be really nice for creating additional separation. And again, a little bit goes a long way. Here's in the middle, and with just a little bit added, add a little bit of post-processed haze to that. And it's kind of a cool effect. There's with and without. You can colorize a black and white photo. You have a really advanced form of a super zoom. which, you know, we can try this out. So if I want to zoom in on my tie, we can sharpen this, we can reduce noise, remove JPEG artifacts. And I don't know if that's a ton better. Maybe if I remove some of the noise reduction. Yeah, I don't know if that looks much better. I mean, it seems like the idea is kind of, you know, on your CSI shows where they're like, enhance, enhance, zoom in, and they take a blurry photo and, like, you know, see what is the VIN number on someone's car as viewed through their rear window or something like that. I think this is kind of the idea behind that, but it's not quite ready. Then they have a bunch of other ones like this face cleanup where you can remove glasses and things, and photo to sketch and sketch to portrait, pencil artwork. But none of these, you just click I'm interested, and then you say that you're interested, but they don't have it quite ready yet in beta. So none of these are actually available, but the potential is interesting. Anyway, that's a brief overview. I figure someone else is interested in it and doesn't want to click through on their own, or maybe they don't have a license. So I hope this is useful. Pass the word along. Bye.